It is your PrisonPlanet.tv memberships that fund so much of what we do here on this operation. And we're more than happy for the TV show after it's aired live, then be leaked out onto the web to tens of millions of people. That's our goal. Live. It is the 25th day of March 2012 on this Sunday edition, and we are locked and loaded, ready to go. Thank you so much for joining us. This is going to be a particularly jam-packed transmission. In the second hour, Lindsey Williams will be joining us. Hadn't been on in about 4 or 5 months. He did say that one of his two living sources, one of them's died, Well, I'm just going to leave it there because then I know the two people's names and then I know which one is living, but then I almost said the one that is living instead of the one that's dead that I'm allowed to say. The point is he has some inside globalist sources whose info is proven in many cases to be very accurate. And he said years ago, there's not going to be an Iran attack. Then he told us 4 or 5 months ago, no, now it is on the front burner coming up by the end of 2012. And he also said, get ready for your gas prices to go back up. That's now started, and much more. So we're going to be having Lindsey Williams join us in the second hour, and I will get him to just get right to his new information and then open the phones up so you can specifically talk to Lindsey. Lindsey's a great guy, and he's one of the most popular guests that we have on. But he's also one of the guests that makes people tear their hair out, because he's always so busy thanking you many, many times and building up the story. I don't think he does that on purpose. That's just the way he is. I've been interviewing him for about 14 years. I remember 14 years ago interviewing him, his book, The Energy Non-Crisis. And since then, it has come out that we've got more oil in Alaska than Saudi Arabia has. But 80% of it is shipped to Asia, 20% to Canada and the United States. It's all part of these cartels trying to keep the price up. That's why Obama has blocked the pipeline now for 6 months under pressure. He said, okay, you can build one part of the southern route, but can't connect the other third at the north. So that's more of his manipulation. Kind of like Obama said, now I'm against this provision where I can secretly arrest or kill U.S. citizens. The snatch and grab secret police provision. And then it turned out he demanded it be added. Those memos are public from the White House to Congress. When Congress got the blame, they released it. And then he said, well, don't worry, I'll veto it so that opposition wouldn't get mounted, so that it would pass. And then he said, I'm not going to sign it. And then he did sign it. And it's kind of like, you know what? You're right. I'm going to let that pipeline get built. One leg at the bottom to make sure his buddy Warren Buffett makes billions and billions on record, as Bloomberg and Reuters reported, now that all that oil has to be shipped, not to the U.S., but by train from those oil fields in central and eastern Canada, and western Canada for that matter, to the western coastline to be sent west, if you're going that direction, or east if you're going the other, to Japan, to China. Because that's the globalist model. China gets its coal power plants. China gets its oil. We don't. It's peak oil here because they're cutting the supply off. So that's all part of this overall program. Now, I haven't even gotten in to the big news yet, and we're going to cover it when we get back. There's lots of little side issues that are interesting. Living almost a record time with an outside-his-body bionic heart pump, 20 months, Dick Cheney, 71, was skipped over others because you're not supposed to get a heart transplant even if you're healthier than he is at 71. But he got one. He's got somebody else's heart. At least he has a pulse again for 20 months with that bionic heart. No pulse with that heart pump that used his heart as a bag to pump the blood through, but had the pump on the outside of his body. There he is holding the heart pump. He's now gotten his heart, and I'm surprised it took this long. I mean, we all know that the head of Apple, Steve Jobs and others, got theirs very, very quickly, got their livers. Okay, look, big MF Global news, big Trayvon Martin news, Big UN news. Tolls for bicycles. Oh, yes. It's all coming up straight ahead. Stay with us. That's right. Blasting out to an audience of over 1.5 million people on the Sunday show. 3 million a day on the weekday show, conservatively. 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central. The websites are Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.tv. The truth sells. The truth is successful. Ron Paul is right. Legalize freedom. That's what this broadcast stands for. Okay, here's what's coming up today. Corzine was caught lying months ago when he testified. I did news reports, radio shows, and wrote articles about that. In December, so did Max Keiser. So did the stockbrokers over at Zero Hedge. The head of the Chicago Mercantile Exchange, tens of trillions monthly that goes through that system, that was regulating privately for the government, MF Global, and the billions missing, said Corzine gave the order and that they'd talked to the top people the day it happened to wire the billions of dollars to J.P. Morgan in London under orders. That was in Congress months and months ago, that this has always been a lie. And if you're a new listener saying, well, why do I care if John Corzine, the former head of Goldman Sachs, who started his own MF Global, who was until just a few months ago the chief private advisor to the White House Economic Council, who had all of his deputies at the different federal regulatory agencies that were regulating him, who actually got part of the money. I mean, there's only five major regulatory agencies over the stock market. In all five, it was his former colleagues or minions, direct minions over it. And he made a 40-to-1 bet with people's private sequestered accounts and lost it. And then the Mercantile Exchange, none of them came in and made the bets good. None of them came in and put money back in people's accounts that had been stolen. Their private sequestered accounts, just like bank accounts. Unprecedented, destroying confidence in the markets. Farmers all over the U.S. hedge their bets by engaging in the futures market. They didn't get their money. At last count, it's around $2 billion gone. And from day one, it was known that John Corzine, the CEO, in a meeting, was told by J.P. Morgan Chase, you will give us the money you owe us. We don't care what you do. Max Keiser, who told us 2 years before they imploded Iceland by design, that he'd been in meetings with people. He used to work with George Soros' son, pretty high-powered guy, invented a lot of the virtual trading systems that are used today, and the high-frequency trading systems that grew out of that. He said that it all went to London. This is like 6 months ago, and that it went to J.P. Morgan Chase, and that he named the head of the company who called up and said, we're going to kill you, Corzine, if you don't give us that money. And by the way, folks, this is the real mafia at that level, not the little, you know, Italian mafia they tell you about. The only organized crime is Italian mafia. That's all that exists. That's a joke. The Italian mafia got a little big for its britches by the 50s, started muscling in on the WASP mafia, the Jewish mafia, the Irish mafia. And that's why they were brushed aside. And that's the untold history. Of course, you know, J. Edgar Hoover told you until 1952, it was a conspiracy theory to even say organized crime existed. You know, the devil's greatest trick was convincing the world he didn't exist. Well, that's certainly the case for the Federal Reserve, private banking cartel, mafias that run this globe. So I'm going to be getting into that report today. Corzine. Congressional panel finds former MF Global CEO ordered JPM fund transfer. MF Corzine ordered funds moved to JP Morgan, memo says Bloomberg. I mean, when he got up before Congress and as the CEO at the time this happened and said, I just knew nothing. and they all went along with it. Even though it had all come out at the time he'd ordered it, the government tracks even $1,000 transfers. They knew about billions. And everybody just played along. But now lawsuits have begun, due process by people wanting their money, so it's coming out. That's why due process, even though the courts are very corrupt and there's not much justice left, the remnant of it is holding back all this tyranny. Because when they spy on us without warrants, it's illegal. Even if the CIA director comes out and says, we spy on you through all your new appliances, there is no Fourth Amendment. He's trying to break your will and just teach you it's okay by announcing the crime. When MF Global takes your private money and steals it, that was in your private account, not even invested. Accounts, people put money in to then trade. They took money that wasn't even in play. And used to, they would pay that back. They're testing to see if they can get away with taking your money, your stocks, your money in 401ks, bank accounts, as is already happening in Europe under banker occupation. They're testing to see if they can do this right now. Here's Politico. Memo contradicts Corzine testimony. We could play the clips of Corzine going, I never knew where it went. And then there's the government acting like it doesn't know where it went. It was in Forbes a week into it 6 months ago that it went to J.P. Morgan. But then, oh, they're not going to pay it back, so let's not discuss where the money went. And then the whole media played dumb. And now, pundits are asking the question, does this mean they can steal any money they want? And yep, he probably won't get in trouble, folks. Because he knows where all the bodies are buried. You know, they've had Treasury Department documents come out in Congress that we've covered, where before anything's done in Congress, there's letters by Treasury Secretary Geithner telling the heads of the banking committees and others, you must call these four men first to get permission. One of them is Corzine. Congress has to get permission from these crooks, and that's what they are. They're crooks, and it's just the emperor's new clothes. When do we say no? When do we realize this is a fraud? When do we get some reality here? Now, again, I've got articles here from Infowars.com, you name it, from December 11th of last year, 4 months ago. Let's go ahead where we laid it all out to you again. Let's go ahead and play a clip of Terrence Duffy, the head of the Chicago Mercantile Exchange, where he wouldn't lie and admitted that Corzine was the one that wired the money, directly contradicting him. And the media didn't even pick up on this. This is 4 months ago. Here it is.
CFTC and CME staff and auditors returned to the firm on Sunday, October 30th, and were informed by MF Global employees that this discrepancy was caused by, quote, an accounting error. Our auditors worked with the CFTC, devoted the rest of the day and night Sunday to find the so-called accounting error. No such error was ever found. Instead, at about 2 a.m. Monday morning, October 31st, MF Global informed both the CFTC and CME at approximately the same time that the shortfall was real and that customer segregated funds had been transferred out of segregation to the firm's broker-dealer accounts. After receiving this information, CME remained at MF Global while MF Global attempted to identify funds that could be transferred into segregation to reduce or eliminate the discrepancy. A CME auditor also participated in a phone call with senior MF Global employees wherein one employee indicated that Mr. Corzine knew about the loans that had been made for the customer segregated from the customer segregated accounts. CME Group has provided this information.
And it goes on to Congress and to the investigators, and nothing was done. Now, when we come back, the rest of the story. Guess who is asking the UN to give them diplomatic immunity? Corzine, the Rothschilds, the Rockefellers, George Soros, and Obama, along with Al Gore. I have the article here. Fox News. Climate Fund seeks UN-style diplomatic immunity. Now they want to get diplomatic immunity and call it environmental, all these scams. Okay, I've gotten off into the Corzine situation. Coming up in the next segment, I'm going to get into the Black Panthers basically calling for race war in this country over the Trayvon Martin case. And doesn't that just play into the globalist hands, this whole divide and conquer situation? I'm going to give you my take on that. Also, The Hunger Games. I haven't seen the film, but I have read some synopses of it, and it's basically more eugenics. Globalist brainwashing. It's broken all-time records for a first weekend, 214 mil. I'm going to be breaking that down. Also, Obama visiting a place that he admires, the DMZ, looking across with binoculars at a place that he loves, the only other country in the world where the dictator president openly says he can secretly arrest people and have them disappear. Nazi Germany didn't put it on paper. They just did it secretly. Communist Russia didn't do it. They just did it secretly. Mao Zedong didn't do it. He just did it secretly. Only North Korea says they'll secretly arrest and kill whoever they want on paper. Until now, 2 weeks ago, China passed their own secret arrest and killing of dissidents law, modeling it after the NDAA. In fact, folks won't believe that. Will you search engine China passes indefinite detention for dissidents bill? It was Reuters. And it said they were very proud of it. See, America can't be the moral high ground now and say things are wrong, torture and things, because the foreign banks run by Corzine and others that have hijacked our country, just ruthless criminals. I mean, it's an admitted banker coup over Europe run by Goldman Sachs. Former head of Goldman Sachs, Corzine, just takes billions of people's private money, lies and says, I was the CEO, I don't know where it went. The government, all run by his former minions, says, well, we don't know where it went. Folks, I went to deposit like $12,000 a few years ago in my bank account because I'd sold a car. And they filled out a suspicious persons thing on me and asked me questions. And I looked at them and I said, you even know who I am? They said, yeah, we just do this on everybody. That's America. Total police state. But the big banks can launder $378 billion in just 2 years. It came out last year in narcotics money and not get in trouble. Well, they got caught finally because people blew the whistle inside. And they got a 1.3% fine. It'd be like if I robbed a bank for $1 million and they said, well, give me a couple thousand, you know. Oh, sure, officer, I'll do that. But, you know, the point is, this is lawlessness. That's what the new world order is. Yeah, here it is. China Parliament unveils dissident detention powers. China's Parliament unveiled legislation Thursday solidifying police powers to hold dissidents in secret, prompting an outcry from activists and human rights watchers worldwide. The ruling Communist Party, however, reiterated that the most draconian part of the rules for one kind of detention, residential surveillance, which were proposed last year. And of course, when you disappear, nobody knows where you went, you die. In fact, our government goes further. They put on paper they'll kill you in a dungeon. The Chi-Coms don't do that because we're land of the free, home of the brave. Sorry, I was digressing. What is the New World Order? It's six big mega banks that aren't free market that are waging war against all other real corporations, private property, families, national sovereignty, anything that stands in their way. They want lawlessness on their part. They have it set up where they're globally exempt, and already the IMF, World Bank, and diplomatic immunity. They're just holding companies for private six banks. Federal Reserve has diplomatic immunity. The UN, they're always caught dealing drugs, kidnapping children, raping people, diplomatic pouches full of cocaine and heroin, sex slaves chained up in their house, you know, dead bodies in trunks. You see it every few weeks. UN people, cops pull them over, you know, they punch the cop in the face. Nothing the police can do. Cops do something, get fired. This is what we're talking about. And it's like, how did the UN get this immunity? Well, they just said they had it because the mega rich want it. And talking to a Rockefeller, the late Aaron Russo, a famous Hollywood director of Eddie Murphy movies, you name it, did production and stuff for, helped bring to the United States groups like Led Zeppelin. The point is, I had that interview with him when he was in Houston dying of cancer, where he went ahead and gave me the photo, everything. Where he met with one of the Rockefellers, he was just in business with them, and they openly said, don't worry, this is 20 years ago. We're all going to get microchips, and ours are going to say, kiss my rear end. The elites are, and they can just drive right through, and their face scan will say that nobody can touch them. They'll have global world government immunity. And that was the offer to Aaron. Join us, get out of the Constitution Party that he started. Don't be part of this, and you will be given, and your entire family, a get-out-of-jail-free card. Now, I already knew that was the plan, but here it was directly from a Rockefeller, Nick Rockefeller in that case. This is Fox News. Climate Fund seeks UN-style diplomatic immunity. And I went and looked it up. The Climate Fund is private. Who created it? Ken Lay of Enron, 1995, with Al Gore. Who's involved? Obama makes money. Go look it up. The Queen of England's invested. The Rothschild family. The Rockefellers are invested in it. They own it. And there's a deal where globally all the money goes through this Rothschild bank. And when you do anything, you pay part of it in a carbon tax on carbon dioxide that you exhale. Now, get this. The Chicago Mercantile Exchange runs this in the United States. And they're trying now to give themselves diplomatic immunity for this new global currency. They're calling the money from this, when they make you pay a global tax into private companies, because private groups make the money, but government enforces it, that they can't be sued, and they can do whatever they want globally. Now you can look up even the New York Times in Uganda and in areas of Central America, not just Africa. The UN goes in and slaughters people that own their own land to make it a carbon sink as part of this. I mean, this is on record. And they're announcing diplomatic immunity. Listen to this. Climate Fund seeks UN-style diplomatic immunity. The Green Climate Fund, which is supposed to help mobilize as much as $100 billion a year to lower global greenhouse gases, it's just a tax to them. You pay them a tax on it. It's already on airlines. There's not even a law. It seeks a broad blanket of UN-style immunity that would shield its operations from any kind of legal process. In any kind. Again, above the law, including civil and criminal prosecution in the countries where it operates. This is just one problem. It's not part of the UN. Well, why does the UN have that? Whether the fund, which is formally created by the UN Climate Conference in Durban, South Africa last December, will get all the money it wants to spend is open to question in an era of economic slowdown and fiscal austerity, which they say they want to do, a post-industrial world. That's Agenda 21. That's their plan. It goes on. A 24-nation interim board of trustees for the Green Climate Fund is slated to hold its first meeting next month in Switzerland to organize the fund's secretariat and to get it running by November. And they admit in the documents it is a global government tax hooked into the SDR. When I mail U.S. Postal overseas to customers that order books and videos and InfoWars, it's already in SDRs. This is the global government takeover with immunity for these criminals. And we are back. Thank you for joining us on this live Sunday transmission. It is 4:33. Central Standard Time today, 5:33 Eastern, I guess that'd be 2:33 Pacific, 3:33 Mountain, or whatever time zone you're in. What does that calculate out to in Greenwich Mean Time or Imperial? We are back live here. Let me just mention some of the other headlines in case I don't get to them ahead of Lindsey Williams with the latest on that big pipeline. You know, it was hidden in Obama's statements this week that they're only going to allow part of the pipeline to be completed and not the other part. So it's just another cynical action. And again, Bloomberg reported a few months ago that it's Warren Buffett who will now make the big profit shipping that oil to the west coast of Canada to have it shipped out to Asia. That's where already 80% of the Alaskan oil goes. Well, that's where most of the Canadians are going to go. All part of the economic espionage against this republic. Now, speaking of that, that's what Agenda 21 is stated to do. Go read it on the UN's own website. They just hope you don't and call people conspiracy theorists that talk about it. But it's global government run by six megabanks that you pay carbon taxes to at your state, county, federal level, and then a large portion is then paid to them. You pay on oil at the wellhead, and then again when it reaches the country, and then when it reaches your pump. You pay then in yearly fees just to have a car, carbon taxes. You pay for your electricity, carbon taxes. People already pay private companies. It's like a carbon indulgence, so I guess they won't go to hell. 500 years ago, people would pay the Vatican to get their family, they would think, out of purgatory. They would call it an indulgence. Oh, here's extra money, or they would buy, you know, things from the from the local church, and they would tell them, do this, and you get your family out of purgatory, and maybe keep them from going to hell. Well, now you just pay Al Gore that money, while they genetic engineer and butcher the planet and toxic waste dump and all this other garbage. They have you worried about carbon dioxide, while China has no restrictions, but we're shut down. So overall output's increasing, too. But never mind that. They're going to have diplomatic immunity now from criminal prosecution when they come to your town and city through the new rural affairs system under Homeland Security. Oh, and you think I'm joking? Just wait. Here is the Washington Post. Homeland Security's morale is at code red. And they go through and break down the fact that they have the lowest morale recorded in the federal government and they hate their job. Well, this is a total fraud. Homeland Security are the ones that helped get the underwear bomber on the plane on record. Homeland Security are the ones that blocked the military from stopping Hassan. Homeland Security runs Al-Qaeda. Homeland Security is caught shipping narcotics in and guns into Mexico to blame the Second Amendment. Homeland Security is the foreign banker agency receivership arm over our federal government. Just like you saw 3 weeks ago when they came in and told Congress, Secretary of Defense, Panetta, he said, we take our orders from NATO and the UN. And they said, no, you take it from the Congress, Article 1, Section 8, Clause 11. And they said, no, we don't. And five times Senator Sessions said, you must retract that. And they said, no. And the military brass eyes gleamed behind Panetta. And then they got up and said, no, we take our orders from the UN. And there's the little castrated Congress just rolled over. Sure, legislation got introduced to begin impeachment for that, but the corporate prostitute media never covered it. Keeping you in darkness. They love it because truth is so much stranger than fiction. Speaking of Agenda 21 and the UN takeover, here is CBS News, New York. After everyone, including bicyclists, 50 cents for bikes, more surcharges on cabs, part of gridlock sham plan. New York has passed more than 80 taxes the last 3 years to pay tax money to the bankers who were propping up and too big to fail. And under Agenda 21, they're going to not just tax your car. This is all Agenda 21. We told you this years ago. But they're going to tax you to ride bicycles and walk. In fact, we've had experts on covering this. We have an excellent book in the online video bookstore at Infowars.com called Behind the Green Mask, Agenda 21. You might want to read it. It's got all the documents in it. You might want to get it to your city council members. But the point is that the Traffic Commission has a new plan to put tolls on East River bridges, but this proposal has some selling points, novel selling points, including a first-ever toll for cyclists. I want to explain something to everybody here. They say you'll have a transponder on your bike. You won't be allowed to pay cash. Of course, that'll track you everywhere as well. But I want to explain something. In the 1920s, there were court cases, you can look them up, that they would sell the public on, hey, there's trucks on the road tearing up the concrete roads we're building for your cars and horses. They're taking commerce. They're making money off the road. They don't deserve that. But any money you put on them as a tax just got passed on in the cost. But the public went, yeah, those rich truck drivers are making money. So they said it was under Commerce Clause of the states of the federal government. This is all on record. And began taxing and set up state police and others to tax trucks by the 30s. They got it in place. Then by the 50s, it was get a driver's license just to make sure your car's safe. It's, you know, 50 cents and here's a piece of paper. Then it's put your face on it by the 70s. Now it's federally, globally standardized. But cops will pull you over and say, it's a privilege to drive. Of course, it's not under common law, not under Supreme Court rulings, not under the facts. Cops have tried to tell you that guns are a privilege. Of course, the public fought back with the facts, and police now know the truth, and have, you know, even the dumb ones have backed off now that, oh, yeah, that is a right, not a privilege, until you're a felon. Before the 68 Gun Control Act, it wasn't even for felons. I say, let felons have guns. Don't touch mine, okay? Because I'm going to kill that felon they come in my house or try to carjack me. A felon's going to have a gun anyways. Now they're starting to go after folks who have misdemeanors for guns, even though there's not a law. They just, through the Knicks, deny you. And you all know about that. It's been in the news and is on record. But the point here is that if they can tax bicycles, and they're already doing this in some areas of China, they're going to tax walking next. I'm not kidding. Well, I mean, look up tax to breathe. That's what Maurice Strong and the UN call for. That's what a carbon tax is. And they're exempt from prosecution while they're running scams on you. They're trying to get you in total immunity right now. I just read to you that article. See, it's so over the top because people aren't awake and aren't resisting. Just like the CIA director, everybody's so blown away. I've been all over different, you know, newspaper interviews and TV stuff. People going, how did you know Google's watching everybody over the camera on all the new computers and phones? How did you know the CIA was dialing in to appliances, data over power line and smart meters? Because it was all in DARPA and Google press releases a decade ago and 7 years ago and 5 years ago. I mean, people, you think I just make this stuff up? I don't make any of it up. Got it? You think I just say the Rockefeller Foundation developed cancer viruses for your vaccines? I link on Infowars.com to their website with the plans in the 50s and 60s. Do you think I just say they're putting stuff in the vaccines to sterilize you and designing GMO crops to do it? I have their own documents. I don't make any of it up. I wish I did. I wish I did. I wish I did. Do you get it through your head? It's real. I feel so sorry for these effeminate, not even effeminate, women are stronger in most cases. This is insult to women. These soft men who get off on giggling at threats to society and laughing at real men who are awake and warning people. You run into them all the time. But they don't count, folks. People that say, oh, all these jellyfish, metrosexual men don't care. They just want to wear their plaid pink and green outfits and prance around. Let them. They don't count. They didn't count in 1776. 3% started the war. 5% won it. Yeah, way more than 5%. So what if a bunch of jellyfish want to be spied on, want to drink bisphenol A and die of cancer? I am a free man, and I declare my independence from it. And you don't have permission to devalue my money and enslave my country and shut off my power systems and try to destroy my children's future. I declare the galactic common law rule of liberty for sentient life forms. Have a right to fight back. Coming up next hour, Lindsay Williams is going to be joining us to talk about the program to shut off our energy supply in this country, the fraud of peak oils. The globalists teach us there isn't any oil, so they can charge us more for less, shutting down the oil refineries. It's not the environmentalists doing that, it's the oil companies, but they love blaming the environmentalists who actually work for them, so they can control the debate and not make it about real environmental issues. Like the fluoride that's left over from oil refining that they then end up dumping in our water supply and making us pay for. It's also mined in fertilizer. No, the oil companies aren't good, and neither are the trendy little liberals. Could slit your throat for a dollar in most cases. They're not liberal, folks. Don't go off the camouflage cover. Go off what they really stand for. You know, I just briefly want to point out here that in New York City, they are calling for, and this is in other parts of the country too, taxing riding bikes on the sidewalk or in the bike lanes. That's always been the plan, not just a registration fee where you got to do that already and have a sticker. That's charging you to travel, but now tolls. And that's always been the plan. You see, you can't toll somebody in their car if they're not involved in a commercial activity. But first they started with trucks because it was commercial. They did have some limited ability there under law. Then it moved to regular cars, and now it's moving to bikes. So you want a nanny state, folks? You got it. And here's CNBC. Oil prices at $200 a barrel. Some think it's coming, and it's already gone up quite a bit since Lindsay Williams predicted it would 4 or 5 months ago on our show. He's been proven right again from his source. He's joining us. Before I get into the Trayvon Martin case and the tragic shooting in a suburb of Orlando, Florida, where we're number one again, two radio books in a row, thanks to the instant people meters. Boy, since those came out, we've gone from doing really well in the ratings, even on smaller stations. The one in Orlando's big, Big 810, but just dominating number one. this Sunday show, in many demographics, is number one. here in Austin on 590 AM, and number two in the big, most important demographic. It's just an example all over the place. Just the truth is just dominating. People are hungry for it. That old cliche of calling me a conspiracy theorist doesn't work anymore. Like that's like a red badge of honor. I wish all the other talk show hosts that just mimic what's on the news and are so cowardly and, of course, have no listeners, I wish all you guys and girls would grow up and defend America when the country needs it. I wish you'd admit, you know what, Alex, you were right. Don't need to give me credit. Don't need to come out and, you know, say how great I am. I don't even want that. I want you to be big enough to admit world government's real and to try to save this country. Because what the globalists are doing is so outrageous. If you would just face reality and admit the world government's being announced, run by mega banks, all of it, we could turn this around. Because I know talk radio is one of the venues that isn't totally controlled. It's mainly just people regurgitating what's on the news. Program directors, that goes to you too. And I know a lot of you are waking up. That's why we're getting put on so many stations. We get calls all the time by program directors going, you know, I thought you were a kook 5 years ago when I first heard you, or 10 years ago as a guest on some other show, or I heard you on a local station. I got to apologize. It's all true. I'm going to put you on our station. We're going to put you on the weekend, see what happens 3 months later. We're going to put you on weeknights, rebroadcast, see what happens. It's doing so well. Oh, my gosh, you've been on 2 weeks. We're putting you on live up against Rush Limbaugh. Boom, number one, boom. That's what happens. You put me up against any of these people, I'll annihilate them because I'll tell it like it is. I know how things work. I do my homework. You know what I did all weekend? All weekend while my children played around me, researched, worked, uploaded reports to Infowars.com, called my writers. You know why? Because I know what's going on. I understand things, and I want you to understand things. I want you to know not my opinion, but my information that is incontrovertible. Incontrovertible. Do I occasionally make little mistakes or get a number wrong? Sure. But overall, I'm trying to tell the truth, and I've got an incredible record of being accurate. And people are figuring that out. And you know what? It's not an ego booster to know that. I know how much danger I'm in. Thomas Jefferson said, there is not a truth existing which I fear or wish or would wish unknown to the whole world. It's a good quote. The point is that it's a great responsibility, as Spider-Man's uncle tells him, with great power comes great responsibility. And I wish more of you who are eloquent, well-spoken, intelligent, who know this is true but think you're going to play it safe and kind of sit on the sideline. That's the mind trick, believing that if you do what's popular, believing if you go with what the main line is, that you're going to be safe in society. When the main line is a bunch of brainwashed sheep giving up on all forms of liberty, that's destruction. Got it? And it's not the American way. It's not the way of free humans. It's the opposite of the Renaissance, the opposite of the Enlightenment, the opposite of everything good. A lot of people are waking up and joining our ranks. Don't wait till it's too late. Okay, I'm going to talk about the Trayvon Martin case. This has been going on for weeks. I've been focused on war with Iran, devaluation of the currency, inflation, the fact that we're really in a depression, huge internet censorship legislation. I've been keeping my eye on other balls. UN taxes, Agenda 21, global government being announced. I've been keeping my eye on that. But a week or so ago, listeners were like, you got to look at this. And I started seeing spam all over my website, Infowars.com, that you must be racist. You're not looking at this. And I'm like, well, okay, I better go look at this. And sure enough, it's kind of like that case that they had with the sports players a few years ago. The Duke lacrosse, because it was a black topless dancer. And they were just all, they were all guilty. They were all rapists. You know, white people are bad. I mean, they're all devils, man. They got tails underneath their pants. I know I got one. I mean, come on. And again, it wasn't even so much black folks saying that. It was the media, because they want divide and conquer. They don't want blacks and whites getting along. Under the name of multiculturalism, they want us all not trusting each other and hating each other. So remember, for years, boy, that whole lacrosse team was guilty, and it turned out it was all bull. Of course, that was a minor footnote because the media didn't want to talk about that. Now, with this Trayvon Martin thing, I don't think it's like the lacrosse situation. neighborhood watch guy. He admittedly was a cop wannabe, this Zimmerman fellow, George Zimmerman. He was reportedly always calling 911, something like 99 times. He followed the guy, got in his face, reportedly. And then some witnesses say that they saw Martin, the guy in the hoodie, climb up on top of Zimmerman, who was in red. And Zimmerman was like a little guy, and Trayvon, you see the pictures when he was a kid, like 12, he was 17, he was a big guy. So the guy got scared, he had a gun. You shouldn't go out waving a gun around just because if the person's leaving your area, it's de-escalated. Okay? I think it's a stupid thing, it's bad. They're going to use this against the Second Amendment and against this right to defend yourself law. It's not defending yourself when somebody's going away from you. Now, if they're stealing your property, it's the old thing of stealing your horse, you're allowed to shoot them because that's your livelihood. But still, I probably wouldn't do it. That said, this is being used by Obama to race bait and divide because, you know, people 4 years ago thought they were getting free houses and everything, and he went along with that. Now they figured out he works for Goldman Sachs, same old scam as Bush, but even worse in many respects. So now it's all about race, and Jesse Jackson and Al Sharpton, the same ones down there with the whole lacrosse situation, they're running around. The Black Panthers are saying $10,000 for his arrest by citizens. That's a total felony to put out bounties on people privately. Super dangerous. They're trying to get $1 million from sports stars. It's all just a bunch of money grubbing and all these Trayvon things. Look, it's murky what happened. We don't know what happened, but bottom line, the media and the globalists love it because it's going to make whites think that blacks are out to get them. It's going to make blacks think that whites are out to get them. And it's going to get us all fighting with each other instead of talking about the depression, the global government, the wars, the police state, the TSA. The last thing they want is the American people coming together. And look, a few years ago when they shot that poor black guy who was handcuffed in the back and said he was resisting on the DART subway thing in San Francisco, I called that day one and said it was terrible. And I said, people starting to riot. I'm not saying it's good, but I get it. When the video got released, they killed that guy in cold blood. I get it, and that was wrong. And I'm glad the cop went to jail. Not long enough, only 1 year. This is an entirely different thing. And why don't black folks get together and come together, 10,000 protesting in all these cities against the drug dealers, or against government shipping the drugs in, or against the fact that 52% of all blacks are never born or aborted? You see, the real racists pose as liberals and sell you on this culture that's destroyed your community. But blacks were just the beta test. The New World Order eugenics family-destroying system is for every community. And the answer is for humans to come together against the psychopathic, technocratic, organized crime guild known as the New World Order. Big hour number two coming up, jam-packed with news, revelations, and the scoop on Obama shutting down our oil pipeline from Canada. Stay with us. Okay, we are into hour number two. Best-selling author, Pastor Lindsey Williams, who 30 years ago was the first to blow the whistle on the fact that there's more oil in Alaska than there is in Saudi Arabia. He's since been proven completely right. He has told us so much here on air that's come true. And he was on, I don't know, 4 or 5 months ago with us the last time. And he said, you know, I've told you for years the Iran attack wasn't coming. Now it's coming in the next year. And I told you, no, enjoy yourself, drive around, have fun. Oil prices aren't going to go up too much until the next 6 months or so. Now it's started, and I have oil prices at $200 a barrel. Some think it's coming. That's CNBC Friday. So we'll have to recap all this in a moment, Lindsey, when we come back from break. But you've got some breaking information that you're going to share with us today, and I appreciate you coming on with us to go over this, sir.
Number of years ago, Alex, some things happened to me that were very unusual. Your listeners will never believe what I'm going to say today unless you give me just a brief moment. I was a pastor of a church for 12 years. I was asked and invited to be the chaplain of the elite of the world, and I lived with them for 3 years' time on the Trans-Alaska Oil Pipeline. For 35 years, I've kept in touch with some of these individuals. One of them died last year, so now you know that I really did know him. He was 87 years of age. Now, just recently, my present individual, who is in his 70s, he has children and a wife, a family. He's very concerned. I have never seen the like. This man has come out in the open. We've had numerous conversations lately. Every few days, he has told me the following. Please have a pencil and paper. You're going to want to write down some facts today. He said, when the financial collapse will take place. Now, I'm going to also tell you when it's not going to take place. Number two, he said, why Mr. Obama may not be reelected. Did you catch that? I said, may not be reelected. You'll be startled. Keystone Pipeline, it fits into all of this, and it's so vitally important. And folks, please, he has told me what currency you must get into immediately. So all of these things I'll try to cover as fast as I can today. Now, Alex, the first thing I'm going to have to say is you have a lot of new listeners out there. I've never been on your Sunday show before. You'll have to verify some of this. I'm going to use the words, I told you so. Last October, November, December, you allowed me the privilege of being on your show. And every newsletter writer imaginable was saying there's going to be a financial collapse. It's going to happen in November or December. And, Alex, I came on your show. It's in your archives. I had gone to my elitist friend. I asked him, and I said it on your show. I said, Alex, there is not going to be a financial collapse in October, November, or December. Then January, February, and March, we're ending up March right now. You allowed me again the privilege of being on your show. I think it was the last of December, the 1st of March. I had just finished talking with my elitist friend, and I came on your show, and I said, folks, I'm going to have to apologize to all my newsletter writer friends out there. Every one of them is saying that the Ides of March, we're going to have a financial collapse.
You did say that. You said, mark it down, take notes, it's on record. You were right again.
And I came on your show and I said it is not going to happen. I'm going to make another prediction right now based on my elite. Folks, the elite know what they're doing. There positively is a group of people on the face of the earth who control the world. Everything has already been decided behind closed doors. And the only reason that I know it is by the providence of God that years ago he allowed me the privilege of living with these people. I gained their confidence, and two of them over the years have told me everything that goes on behind closed doors, and never once has it failed. Here's the prediction. There will not be a financial collapse during April, May, and June. You have my word on it. The elite said it's not going to happen, but I am going to tell you today when it is going to happen.
Whoa.
But I had to say I told you.
Lindsay, you are totally cutting to the chase. This is awesome. And again, I knew who his one source was. I knew who the other was because they're both hiding in plain view. One's dead now. Lindsay Williams years ago, was covering all this, and our good friend Dr. Monteef, being the journalist he is, still called the guy and was like, how do you know my name? Yeah, I'd wasn't telling him that. Don't say my name. And that fella died of cancer. I know who the other Mr. X is. We're going to break all this down when we come back. This is super powerful. This is going to be some very important information you're going to hear in the next 55 minutes or so in the second half of this Sunday transmission. It's so important. I'm obviously going to have Lindsay back up on the weekday show. That's 11 to 2 Central, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central, because what he just dropped on me the last week or two, we've been talking to him a lot off air, and he wasn't quite ready to go on yet. He is sticking his neck out here. I want to introduce him here briefly. 30 years ago, he wrote The Energy Non-Crisis that was a bestseller over the next two decades in the aggregate. He had worked as the chaplain on the Trans-Alaska Pipeline on the big drilling rigs for 3.5 years. This happens commonly that the elite will bring in a pastor generally to be a liaison. In fact, most big boards have that in the field to the roughnecks. He got picked. So he was in their elite compound with swimming pools and all the rest of it, but out in the field, staying in the tents with them. And he got to know two big, one a CEO, one a head of operations for a major two major oil companies. I've known who they've been for a decade. I went back into the 80s and found them actually on record. One of them's actually been at a speech with Williams, but got in so much trouble he shut up about it. Got fired, got hired back. Now, one of them died of cancer a year ago, so we can now talk about him. Ken Fromm. The other guy, I don't even like to say Ken Fromm, was almost say the other guy's name. Mr. X, we'll call him, is 80-something years old, still alive, retired former CEO of one of the big five oil companies. Everything Lindsay's given us, we separately have confirmed through Bilderberg sources, but we only get that intel once a year. By the way, that's coming up in about a month, and we're tracking that right now. It may be in the U.S. Some are saying Haifa over in Israel. We're not sure. The point is that all this is going on. Now, he said, I don't know, 4 years ago or so, that oil would go to $150 a barrel. Everybody laughed at him. It was at 50. It went to that. Then he said, everybody's saying it's going to 200. No, it'll go below 50. It dropped to 40, exactly as he said. He said that before it started dropping, and he said the time frame. His elitist sources have been right about 95% of the time. Now, they said 2 years ago, won't be an Iran attack. 6 months ago, they said now one is on the front burner in the next year. They said no economic collapse last year, as a lot of folks were saying. But Lindsay has these sources, and I know who the one source is. Now, we only got about 5 minutes left in this segment. We're going to come back and cover it all here. But this is a big deal. It also ties into the Keystone Pipeline that Obama killed. So Warren Buffett can make money shipping the oil to the West Coast, to then to China, onto the big oil tankers. He'll make billions a year off that. Even Bloomberg reported that. In fact, guys, put in the term for viewers that are watching at PrisonPlanet.tv. Radio listeners can just search this. But I want to show it to people. Buffett stands to gain from Keystone being shut down. And then Bloomberg. I'm going to show him that from a few months ago. Obama has the nerve, when that heat got to him on gas prices going up, to come out and say, well, I'm going to allow the southern leg to be built. That's already built. He killed the middle leg. That's deception. That's deception. Okay, Lindsay, recap what's coming up, the bombshells you're about to drop, and then we're going to come back and get into them, because you just told me some incredible stuff that your elites have told you. Go ahead.
Please, everyone in the listening audience, I beg of you to listen to my concerned elitist friend, who is now up with a grown family. He's very concerned about America. And may I say, we must take immediate action. America, as we know it today, is doomed. You have a time frame right now. You have a window of opportunity right this minute that is going to, you're going to find it amazing. Okay, Alex, what do you want me to cover first? You want me to cover the financial collapse? You want me to cover the Obama and the pipeline or the currency? We got three subjects here. Whether I can get them all in today or not, I don't know.
Well, just recap that you're elitist friend. You're not talking to him once a month now. You're not just by email. You're on the phone with him, and he's freaked out. Start wherever you think it's most important.
I have made the statement, as was given to me by Mr. Fromm, long time before he ever passed away, that by the end of 2012, the dollar would be dead. And you need to understand this in order to understand.
You said that 3 years ago. I'm just backing you up. You said that 3 years ago. Go ahead.
Yes, and it will be. Now, let me show you what's happening, just in case you picked it up. First of all, don't pay any attention to the New York stock market. It means nothing. It is not an indicator of anything. It did not say that the dollar would be non-existent. They said the dollar would be dead. I want to show you how it's already dying, and then you'll put the pieces together. Again, please have that pencil and paper handy and write these things down, put them beside your calendar. Just about 2 months ago, China and Japan signed the largest trade agreement that's ever been signed in the history of the world, saying they would trade amongst themselves. China being the second largest economy in the world, Japan being the third, I believe, now with America the first. When they did that, it was in the agreement, there will not be the use of the reserve currency of the world, the petrodollar, which is the American dollar.
And by the way, India is almost more populous than China now. They've now left the U.S. and England as being our staunch ally. They've now teamed up with China publicly. They've always been enemies. This is a big power shift, and they've said they're going to move away from dollars.
No American dollar. That was the first nail that was hammered into the coffin of the American dollar as the reserve currency of the world. Then Iran, we put sanctions on them. The European Union came along and said no European Union country can buy any oil from Iran after June the 1st. The United States of America said you cannot use the American dollar to buy, sell, or trade oil with Iran. And then the United Nations came along and put on more sanctions. Iran was in a mess. They're the third largest supplier of oil on the face of the earth. 3.5 million barrels of oil every 24 hours. Iran needed to sell their oil. India needs oil. India stepped up and said, Iran, we will buy 1 million barrels of oil from you every 24 hours, but Iran says we can't sell it and use the American dollar. Oh, my goodness, folks, we shot ourselves in the foot as the United States of America. I can't believe our stupid State Department. India came along and said, Iran, we want that million barrels of oil every 24 hours, and we will pay you in gold. Can you imagine not getting funny money paper or Federal Reserve notes?
This is what's scaring me. Their top advisor, top globalist, John Corzine, publicly lied to Congress and is now being caught stealing money, and he's one of the top guys. It shows they're just a bunch of crooks behind a curtain. It's scary.
Do you see it, folks? China and Japan, largest trade agreement on the face of the earth ever signed. No American dollar. Iran and India, no American dollar. Folks, the dollar is going to be dead by the end of 2012, and the third one that maybe you haven't heard of, and you probably wouldn't unless you knew my elitist friend, Saudi Arabia supplies us with more crude oil than any other country on the face of the earth, and they have betrayed us. They came along and said, okay, China, you need oil. And they're building it right now. The largest oil refinery ever built on the face of the earth has been built in China right now by Saudi Arabia. And the agreement between Saudi Arabia and China is we will not use the American dollar for the sale and the trade of this crude oil. China and Japan, Iran and India, Saudi Arabia and China, in 2 months' time, the dollar has begun to die as the petrodollar of the world, the reserve currency of the world. Now we're coming down to a collapse of the American dollar that is going to be utterly appalling. I have said it, I've been told by my leader's friend, it will not happen yet. And there's a reason why. It's more important that you know the reason why the elite have not allowed the dollar to collapse yet. It's more important than knowing that it's going to collapse or even knowing the date that it's going to collapse. Why are they not allowed? It should have collapsed at the end of the Bush administration, and they came along with QE1 and QE2. Then they didn't allow it to collapse again this past year, and it should have in October, November, or December.
No, it should have. I had a lot of folks that we have on who really thought it was going to happen because they were saying QE3, but they didn't. Now they're saying it is coming. Stay there. That means hyperinflation, ladies and gentlemen. That means a currency tax. We'll be right back with Lindsey Williams on the other side. Amazing information. You can find out about the DVDs and things he's done at prophecyclub.com. Alex Jones here, back live. Lindsey Williams, our guest. In Ayn Rand's book that she wrote back in, the 50s, Atlas Shrugged, an elite group of crony capitalists within Washington start shutting down all their competition. Because if you shut down your competition, that automatically increases your bottom line. And that's what's plagued so many real countries. That's what happens under fascism, communism, and other command and control systems. Well, that's what we have here today. I mean, I've got the oil company documents from 15 years ago, the AP got, Associated Press, where they said, buy up all the refineries and shut them down because there's too much oil coming and we got to jack up prices. And they even say in the memos, we'll blame the environmentalists. You think a bunch of idiots in sandals are controlling the oil companies? No. Again, the average liberal or conservative has no idea how they're gamed. And unfortunately, about 95% of what Lindsey has said over the years from his sources has turned out to be frighteningly accurate. I remember one thing is the elites thought that Obama would not get elected. They said McCain was their man. That was one thing they were wrong about. And I wish they were wrong about more because I've got similar type sources. I remember Jim Tucker right around the time that Lindsey said all this, said they're going to pump oil up to 150. And then next Bilderberg, they're like, people are getting too angry. We're going to lower it. But now they're saying they're going to tax bicycles and walking. That's CBS News, folks. Agenda 21. Going back to Lindsey Williams. Lindsey, let's get in to the Arab Spring being financed by these guys. You called it a year before the Arab Spring was even on the radar. Never been heard of. You said they're going to overthrow the Middle East through proxy wars. Your source did. Well, that was Fromm. He's dead now. I want to know what Mr. L has to say. It's not really Mr. X. The currency, you're saying it's not going to crash during the summer, but then, I mean, go over it all. Just hit it bullet point after bullet point, Lindsay.
There's a window of opportunity right now that is so wonderful and so much to all of us's advantage. We must see the elite stopped. We positively must see the New World Order brought to an end. And they have shot themselves in the foot in that they have given us this window of opportunity, Alex. And folks, I want you to hear everything that Alex says every day because he's warning you and telling you on a daily basis. You remember that every newsletter writer out there, and many of them are friends, and I don't like saying this, but every one of them was saying, whenever Greece's economy collapses, the European Union and the euro is going to go with it. I mean, without exception, every newsletter writer that I know of was saying...
Everyone but Bob Chapman. Every guest but you and Bob Chapman was saying that, basically.
Good. Well, I'm glad to know Bob didn't say it. And when Greece collapsed, the euro didn't collapse. And I wasn't on your show, Alex, because it's been a while since I've been with you. But on many other shows that's in their archives, I said the euro is not going to crash whenever Greece crashes. Okay, here we go. Please write this down in your notes. Why have the elite not allowed the financial system of the world to collapse yet? A reason. I told it on your show earlier, very briefly right now. The elite told me, they said, we are not going to allow the collapse of the financial system of the world, not just the United States of America, whether it be the euro, America, China, Japan, it matters not. We are not going to allow the crash to take place. And it is going to happen, folks, please. It is going to happen. But they said, not yet. And I said, why? They said, we want to create such massive debt in every nation in the world, every city in America, every county in America, every place, every state. We want to create such massive debt that whenever we finally do decide to, and they are going to, and they know the date they're going to do it, and whenever it takes place, they said, we will have caused such massive debt all over the world that we can step in and say, Greece, you have no choice. We bought you. Have you ever wondered why they took 50% loss on the paper that they bought out of from Greece, their bonds and so on? This is all a part of the plan. They'll step into Greece and say, Greece, you have no choice. Your currency has failed. The only way for you to do is forget about your constitution, the United States of America. Your dollar is toast. And that you must accept our new world order.
Yeah, no, they openly put Goldman Sachs alumni in as the appointed prime ministers and presidents in Italy, Greece, you name it. And even in the Financial Times of London, they call it banker dictatorship and say it's a good thing because they're loaning them fiat made up digits and getting real infrastructure back.
But do you realize what a marvelous, folks, everybody out there, do you realize what a marvelous opportunity and a window of opportunity we have right now to do everything that Alex is talking about in saving America and turning it around? They are shooting themselves in the foot by waiting, but they are intentionally doing it in order to create this massive debt. Then they'll step into the United States of America.
Sure, take the world into global receivership. So tell us what your former oil company executive, known to myself, we're not going to reveal him here because of journalistic standards, what he told you about when they are planning the Iran attack, when they or if that's on the table, and when they do plan to have the dollar dead.
For the time being, Iran, don't pay any attention to it. Mr. Obama may use it at the very last minute before the election if he has to or wants to. It'd be terribly dangerous for him to. But I don't think you, from what my elitist friends are indicating, I don't think you'll see anything with Iran and Israel anytime soon. Now, let's go down to the dollar because, as you know, the most sensitive part of anybody's anatomy is the rear pocket. And recently I'm going to give a name now. I hope you have that pencil and paper ready. You've got to write it down. Just recently I was put in touch with a Wall Street insider. You may recognize him, Alex, or you can go look him up if you don't. This man was many years on Wall Street as an insider, and he is verifying what my elitists have told me. His name is Tom Fowler,
yes.
Y-L-E-R. And he, for years, was considered one of the Wall Street insiders. And what my elitist friends told me and what he said, Lindsay, I've known him for about a year now. They put me in touch with him a while back. And he said, Lindsay, let's compare notes. we compared what he saw on Wall Street on the inside and what I heard from my elitist friends, and we experienced the identical same things, except he got it out of Wall Street, I got it out of my friends. He got so sick of the corruption on Wall Street until he left. You can talk to him personally, by the way. You'll find out how later on if you would. Here's what we came up with, and here's what my elitist friends have told me. Do you want to know when the financial collapse is going to take place, when it will happen? First of all, do not pay any attention to the New York stock market. It is not an indicator of anything.
It's totally rigged. So what did he tell you?
Then you do not pay any attention to the euro. The euro is not an indication either. And as you know, my latest friend told me you've got 2 to 3 weeks after the euro crashes before you've got to be out of paper or you'll lose it. Don't pay any attention to crude oil prices. There is a word that I hope you know what the meaning of it is, and if you don't, you've got to do a crash course on it immediately. And here is what's just been said, and I'll give you the background to it. Number one, you must write down the word derivatives. Don't pay any attention to the stock market, the euro, nor the crude oil prices. The indicator as to when the financial collapse will take place is the derivative market.
Sure, it's when they stop propping those up. Absolutely. Yeah, that's a no-brainer.
The derivatives begin to crack.
Yeah, but exactly. And then you were saying they also told you that Obama may not get reelected. Why they think that? I want to get into the Keystone Pipeline and more with Lindsay Williams, our guest. And yes, we'll take a few phone calls for him. I'll give you the number on the other side. All right, Lindsay Williams is our guest for two more segments. This is really going quick. And I really wish that this information was not accurate. But undoubtedly, we know a global government's been formed. We know they're devaluing the currency. They're talking about QE3 now, quantitative easing 3, which will really accelerate the devaluation of a currency and increase prices across the board while we have other depressionary factors in the economy. We're going to be discussing that in a moment. I wanted to tell you, Lindsay's got a new documentary presentation. He's put out several over the years, but a new one with all this information codified in it. And you can simply go to prophecyclub.com. That's prophecyclub.com to get it. It's titled Secrets of the Elite. You can order it, I think, right now, but it's not going to be out till later in the week. They just completed it. Or you can give them a call, 888-799-6111. Again, Secrets of the Elite, prophecyclub.com, or 888-799-6111. And I'll double-check that website and email and phone number here with him in just a moment. But I thought I'd plug that now for him in the interest of time. Also, speaking of the InfoWar, we have an online video bookstore at InfoWars.com. And when you wear an InfoWars.com shirt, that's how you meet like-minded people that are into freedom. And your purchase of the shirt also supports this broadcast, the nightly news organization I've set up, the documentary films, all of it is listener-supported when you visit InfoWars.com and support the sponsors, but also visit the online video slash apparel area. Lastly, if you're watching on the internet streams, not just the audio, but watching me, you can see that I've lost close to 40 pounds. And I've done that by taking vitamin and mineral drinks that are second to none from organic sources, like Beyond Tangy Tangerine with the Mighty 90 minerals and vitamins, trace elements, pollen burst full of B vitamins, antioxidants, increase energy, reduces oxidative damage and stress, Rebound's a great sports drink, with a lot of B vitamins and stuff. Cell Shield is the ultimate in the antioxidants. And it's all available at InfoWarsTeam.com. That's InfoWarsTeam.com. And you can also go there and sign up to be a distributor and buy wholesale and get discounts. You can also sign up to get free shipping there at InfoWarsTeam.com and watch videos and more about that. Very, very exciting. I only promote what I believe in. And look at the difference here. I was already swimming and running and never really lost any weight. And I wasn't even eating that much. I wasn't getting the vitamins and minerals I needed. Now, I eat about half of what I did, and I just drink vitamin mineral drinks 2 or 3 times a day. It's amazing. InfoWarsTeam.com. Okay, going back to Lindsay Williams, just briefly. Lindsay, did I give that number out right, 888-799-6111?
Alex, you're doing a great job. That's exactly right. You're always right.
No, I'm not always right.
Too many of your radio shows.
No, no,
right
no.
All the time.
I was just looking at prophecyclub.com. I know for a decade they've put out your material and stuff. And then I was noticing you have this new film coming out. And I want you to tell us about that in the next segment. We got to move quick now. Let's go over all the points you mentioned right at the front. You said that your former oil company executive source, again, known by me and others in the media, but we're not giving out his name because he wants to be private, is pretty freaked out right now. It looks like things aren't going like the elite, the Western elite planned. You have China and India are playing more patty cake with Russia, who they've not gotten along with in the past, and are moving away from the dollar. Again, I mean, kind of give us a hard-boiled date. He's still saying by 2012, you'll see basically the beginning of the end of the dollar. I mean, let's just run through them in rapid fire now and then get into Keystone.
Yes, the dollar will be dead by the end of 2012. Please, you need to understand, Tom Fowler was actually on Wall Street many, many years ago when the word derivative was used for the first time.
Isn't he a writer for the Wall Street Journal?
Very well could be. I don't know all of his background, but you'll find him up there when you look him up. And he was told what derivatives were. He was told by his superiors to see to it that they were used. And then only a few weeks, I mean, this testimony is so fabulous, you're going to be amazed. He was told a few weeks later, Tom, don't tell people what they're going to be used for. And he calls them the powers that be. I call them the elite. And one of them came to him and said, Tom, now this was way back many years ago when the word derivative was first used. Nobody had heard it before then. Wasn't even in the dictionary. And they came back to him and they said, Tom, we are going to use derivatives in order to bring down the entire financial system of the world. And this was said nearly 20 years ago. My elitist friend just recently said, Chaplin, don't pay any attention to the stock market, the euro, crude oil prices. None of it means anything. He said, you watch derivatives and you will know exactly when we are going to bring it down. Let me express very quickly how derivative works. I'll try to do this as fast as I can. A guest walked into a hotel. He walked up to the desk in the lobby and put a $100 bill down and said, I'd like to see a room. I'd like to stay here tonight, possibly. As soon as he walked off to look at the room, the hotel owner runs and pays the bakery that he owed $100 to. The bakery goes across the street as fast as he can and pays the bill at the flour mill. The person at the flour mill, the owner, goes immediately and gives that $100 to his mistress who lives at the hotel. The mistress pays the hotel the $100 on her room rent. Then the guest decides he's coming back to the desk and he says, I don't want to stay in your room. I'm not satisfied. Give me my $100 bill back. Now, that's a very simplified what a derivative is. And if we ever have enough time, I'll give you some pure living examples. What you've got to poke you.
Sure, there's 1.5 quadrillion. Our listeners know a lot about derivatives, Lindsay. It's 1.5 quadrillion. It's basically insurance and credit default swaps on other investments. And it's basically counterfeit. It's beyond fractional reserve banking. It's beyond the money changers. It's a total fraud, and that's what we've signed on to is an impossible black hole. So they're still saying by the end of 2012, you'll see the end of the dollar or the beginning of the end.
Okay, let's go to the Keystone Pipeline. My, is it important that the average person didn't have the slightest idea what it was all about? Now, you've got to put on your thinking cap for a moment. Remember that Mr. Obama said that on a certain date he was going to announce his decision about the Keystone Pipeline. He didn't. He waited 2 weeks. Please, remember, think back. He waited 2 weeks. Why was he waiting? And when he finally said, it's not in the benefit of America to do this, he literally lost thousands and thousands of jobs, which he says he wants to create. He not only did that, but millions and probably billions of dollars was lost by the United States and its financial system. I immediately went to, you know who he is, Alex. I went to my elitist friend and I said, why did Mr. Obama cancel out on the Keystone Pipeline across Canada? He was livid. I have never heard this man so angry in my life. The elite right now, folks, this is so much to your advantage. It's amazing. The elite right now are so angry at Mr. Obama, they may not allow him to be reelected as president of the United States of America. Let me try to explain why. Now, go on the internet and prove this just for yourself. After the program, don't you change that dial right now, but after the program, go on the Internet and look up Liberty Rig. This is the oil rig that was moved last summer to Prudhoe Bay, Alaska, and was put on Gull Island. It's the largest pool of oil on the face of the earth. It is the mother lobe of all oil. In my book, Energy Non-Crisis, I said it 35 years ago, but nobody ever believed me. Now they will believe me because the Liberty Rig is actually there. They know that that oil is going to come in approximately sometimes after next summer, and they had to have a way to bring that oil to market.
And he doesn't want us to have that oil.
They cannot take it through the Arctic Ocean. It freezes over for 9 months out of the year, and they cannot take it down the Trans-Alaska oil pipeline.
And Obama is killing it. He wants to give it to Warren Buffett to ship out. Stay there. We're going to come back and break this down with Lindsey Williams straight ahead with his inside sources on Alex Jones at InfoWars.com. Yeah, it's falling apart for John Corzine, caught perjuring himself to Congress, but don't worry. His criminals run all the major regulatory agencies. All the genetic engineering, all the reactors, 9 out of 10 leaking because they don't even care about upgrading them because the bankers make more money, so their reactors are blowing up and leaking everywhere and their grandkids are getting radiation poisoning just like yours. Yeah, there's always time in life for this. I would stand in line for this. All you New World Order people think you're creating such a great thing. You're creating a nightmare. By the way, big Billy Corrigan interview that I did a week and a half ago when he was in town. He came into the office. He's been a listener for many years. I've been a fan since the early 90s. Smashing Pumpkins. He talks about the New World Order, global warming, religion, everything. We're going to air that tomorrow night, 7 o'clock. InfoWars Nightly News, hour plus interview after the news. Then I'm going to air some excerpts of that, like I did with Dave Mustaine a few weeks ago, on the radio show. But it's big. It'll be a headline maker as well. We have some other very important guests joining us this week. I'll just leave it at that for you. And, of course, the place to visit is InfoWars.com. There's a new video, well, several videos I shot today up on InfoWars.com. The Secret of Soft Kill. What is soft kill? Find out. At InfoWars.com. Also, nanny state on steroids. City plans to outlaw smoking in apartments. Kurt Nemo. Well, some cities have banned it in your own house. But what about nanny state charging you to walk or ride a bicycle? Stuff like that's coming to New York and other areas. Total enslavement. So we're going to be breaking all that down. If you can't walk or ride a bicycle, folks, you're a prisoner. So that's coming up. Lindsey, I want to get back to the Keystone Pipeline and Gull Island and the oil. Why would Obama, as Bloomberg and AP reported, kill that pipeline under pressure? Now, say, okay, I'll allow the southern route when that's already built. It's the middle route he's still blocking. So he's playing stalling games. Why is this so important for the traitor in chief?
I'm going to give you one of those startling statements you've ever heard. And in just a moment, briefly, let me go back. The largest oil rig that's ever been built on the face of the earth was moved to Prudhoe Bay, Alaska, up on the Arctic Ocean in northern Alaska this past summer, and was placed on Gull Island. Go on the Internet, and you can see it in the construction phase, and you'll see it sitting on the island. They know that the mother lobe of all oil fields is there under that Gull Island. They must bring that oil out. They were depending on the Keystone Pipeline to get it to market somewhere in the world, wherever they wanted to take it. They cannot carry it through the Arctic Ocean. It freezes over 9 months out of the year. They cannot take it down the Trans-Alaska Oil Pipeline. Briefly, quickly, let me tell you why. The Trans-Alaska Oil Pipeline, every so many days, they run what is called a pig down it. They've been doing it for 35 years. You in the oil patch, you know exactly what I'm talking about. It's a big ball, and all around it is little things like razor blades, and it cuts the paraffin that is collected on the side of the pipe, and if they didn't run it every so many days, it would clog up. That has caused the pipe to be so thin, they cannot run 2 million barrels of crude oil down it any longer. Plus, the state of Alaska will not allow them to build another pipeline at this point. Therefore, the elite had no choice but the Keystone Pipeline. All right, you ready? Here it is. I'm going to give you the statement. I call my elitist friend, and I'm going to tell you exactly what he said. I hope this doesn't hurt. I hope it does affect you very much. I said, why did he cancel on the Keystone Pipeline? He said, you ready? He is a Muslim. I said exactly what this man said. I did not change a word on it. He said he is a Muslim. I said, wait a minute. Are you telling me that he canceled out on the Keystone Pipeline in favor of his Muslim brethren and the Muslim Brotherhood? He said, yes, Chaplain. Mr. Obama, the President of the United States of America, has double-crossed the elite. He is in big, big trouble. He may not get reelected. They may see through it. He doesn't. He has committed a crime amongst all the elite that is unreal. Therefore, we had to go back and waffle a little bit and say, okay, we'll talk about the southern end. Mark my words. He'll probably go back and let the whole thing be built after a while. You know why he wanted to do this? The Muslims gave him literally millions of dollars for his campaign 3 years ago. He waited 2 weeks. Folks, remember back what I said a moment ago? He waited 2 weeks from the day he said he was going to announce this. Why? He was waiting on his Muslim brother to give him, again, promise him millions of dollars for his next presidential election campaign. The elite know it, and the word that this man used, he was so livid. He said, Chaplain, he is a Muslim. And I said, you mean he canceled out on it in favor of his Muslim brethren? He did. Alex, this is so much to our favor, you cannot imagine. This may be one of the greatest things that ever happened to us in a long time, because right now the elite are mad, Alex.
Go ahead, Lindsay.
Well, that basically is the story on the Keystone Pipeline, and as of right now, that rig at Prudhoe Bay, Alaska is drilling, 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 and they know it's coming in probably after next summer, and they...
Well, bottom line, we know that they killed the pipeline, and now they already built the southern part and the northern part. Everybody knows it's the middle he killed, so he parades around in front of the pipeline and says, okay, I built it, and I'm going to allow it to be turned on. I mean, I thought he was doing this, as Bloomberg said, for Warren Buffett, who can now ship by train the oil out of Canada to the West Coast to super tankers to take it to Asia. We know 80% of the Alaska oil already goes there. I mean, look, I hear this Muslim stuff, and I know his real name was Barry Sotero. That's on record. I know he gave up his U.S. citizenship in Indonesia and did go to a Muslim school. That's been confirmed, folks.
Well, I know they're
financing the Al-Qaeda revolutions, all the Middle East, and putting Al-Qaeda in, but are you telling me that Mr. X, who I know, the former head of a big five oil company, the elite really believe he works for the Muslims? Well, the Muslims work for the New World Order, the Muslim leadership over there. Well, I mean, Saudi Arabia does, but...
He wanted the oil brought in from Saudi Arabia, other countries, instead of the elite providing it from the North Slope of Alaska.
But the elite, as you know, always did the deal to not let the oil come out of Alaska because they had a deal with the Saudis. So it sounds like Obama's sticking with the old deal.
Yeah, Obama has really messed up everything with the elite right now, and they are livid with him. The real reason that you've never been told on the news, I don't even know a newsletter writer that knows this. I wouldn't have known it if I had not called this friend of mine on the phone. And the real reason he canceled out on Keystone Pipeline is because the oil that will be coming out of Gull Island must be brought to market. They were depending on the pipeline all the way across Canada and going into Alaska with it and bringing that oil out. And now, of course, he has canceled out on it.
And well, yeah, because you said a year and a half ago the elite were going to, or almost 2 years ago, they were going to double-cross the Muslims, cut them off on that deal they had to have the Muslims use the dollar, but then they would only buy the oil from the Middle Eastern, predominantly Muslim countries. You did say that. You said they would destabilize it. So they were right about that. You were the first to say it. And now you're saying Obama is double-crossing somehow? Well, I mean, is that good then to have the elite double-cross? I mean, in a way, that makes Obama good.
Oh, I mean, it's wonderful that Mr. Obama has done this because they may not let him get reelected. They have the power to keep him from being the next president of the United States of America.
Well, no kidding. Yeah, I mean, he's a teleprompter reader. But you're implying Obama's actually running something. And we haven't had that really since somebody like Nixon or somebody. I mean, you're saying Obama is really running things?
Well, Obama has double-crossed the elite. He intentionally did it in favor of his Muslim Brotherhood. And when this man said to me, and this was his one expression, and you could hear all of the animosity in his voice when he said it, he said, he is a Muslim, just like that. And I said, what, you mean he double-crossed in favor of the Muslims? Yes. And Alex, this is so wonderful for us. I did not say they weren't going to let him reelected. I said they may not because they're so angry at him right now. They've got to bring that oil out somehow.
All right, you specifically said before we went live, though, that he gave you the time of the collapse. Is it still, because you were right, it wasn't years ago, are they still saying it's going to be the end of 2012?
Well, the dollar will be dead by the end of 2012. The financial collapse will take place worldwide. It won't only be the America dollar, it's going to be the euro, it's going to be the currencies of the world.
But the inflation won't be felt here until last. For those that don't know, when a country hyperinflates its currency, especially if it's a global or regional, the effects are felt last in the country. But you're saying by the end of this year, the dollar's dead, and then I guess 6 months for it to really be felt here or quicker?
Well, exactly when the worldwide collapse. Now, what I'm talking about today, whenever I say when is the financial collapse, I'm talking about a worldwide, not only America, euro, other currencies.
Well, it's already happening in many areas. Thank you so much, Lindsey Williams. Prophecyclub.com, newest DVD film, Secrets of the Elite, prophecyclub.com. Thank you so much, Lindsey. We'll talk to you again this week. We'll get you back on to take phone calls. I said I'd take phone calls, but never gave the number out. Will you come back on later during the week?
Gladly, Alex. I'd consider it a privilege.
Okay,
have
wonderful.
A wonderful day.
Thank you so much. Everybody be safe out there until 11 a.m. tomorrow Central, and we'll see you back live then, and Lindsey will be on with us later. Infowars.com.